gave you a vote of confidence after the season was over, saying you'll be back next year and hopefully many years to come. When did they tell you that they were exercising that 2021 option?
I guess officially a couple weeks ago. This year's been, such a crazy year, obviously, that, there's been so many more things that are important to focus on. And I've tried to kind of keep my focus there as well. And I know that'll all take care of itself in due time. And, love being a part of this organization. And, hopefully it is something that we do over the long term and continue this, but it's not something in all that 2020's been, it's something that I've tried not to really focus too much on, because I know there's so many other things going on in the world and within our organization that in due time, that'll take care of itself.
Aaron, you mentioned the craziness that was the 2020 season and really what's still happening now. How do you wrap your head around all of it and the way the 60-game season went?
Oh man. Grateful that we got to do it. Pretty awesome endeavor that I think Major League Baseball and the Yankees and every organization took on, and to be able to complete a season, I think have a successful, albeit unique and different postseason, was certainly a challenge, but one that, in reflection, as difficult and as hard, and I use the word heavy a lot, it was just a heavy year on so many fronts and a challenge day in and day out. Looking back, you feel grateful to have taken part in it and to have gotten through it in the way we did.
Are you confident there will be 162 in 2021?
I'm hopeful. Certainly hopeful. One thing this year's taught you is not to be confident in too much that's around the corner. So, hopefully there continues to be some good news on the vaccine front and that continues to develop. And, hopefully we can get through this winter as a country and kind of weather the storm, if you will. And, I'm certainly hopeful that we can have a normal 162 game season. I certainly miss that prospect.
I imagine there will be some residual effects from the shortened season. How do you go about managing guys knowing that they did not play the entire time in 2020?
Yeah, I mean, again, like we do in everything that we try to evaluate, you try and evaluate guys individually and try and, give them what they need, try to put them in the best position moving forward and make solid evaluations about what they're going to be capable of doing. We've got some guys that are going to be playing some winter ball, getting more at bats, getting more time on the mound, so that'll be valuable. Obviously a lot of our guys in player development, a lot of our young prospects, missed out on some important developmental time. So hopeful that those guys can really catch up in a lot of ways. Especially such a crucial time in their career. And that's going to be the challenge that every organization faces is trying to continue to develop their prospects. But also, as we move forward in the 2021 season, getting guys in the best, safest position to go out and perform at their highest level. And that's a challenge every year, but in going into this next season will be a little different, a little more unique in making those evaluations.
Is it particularly difficult when it comes to the pitching staff, gauging not only where guys are, but what they can handle, not only some of those youthful players that you spoke about in the prospects, but also the veterans as well?
Yeah, I think you more look at that from the youth guys, the guys that, haven't, built up to, from a pitching standpoint, innings built up and things like that. Some of the more veteran guys, you feel like will be more equipped to handle it. So I don't worry too much about that. We'll try and be smart in how we carve out what their spring will look like ultimately into the early season and then how we build them up from there. But that'll be more of a challenge for, I think, some of the developmental guys and some of our younger players.